Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. My name is Gila Kristen Rafael, and for today, I will discuss the discipline of communication. What is communication? This with how humans use verbal and non-verbal messages to create meaning in various contexts. Communication is essentially transactional, giving and receiving content, which may take a wide variety of forms. Communication is a process concerning exchanges of facts or ideas between persons holding different positions in our organization to achieve mutual harmony. Communication process as such must be considered a continuously and dynamic interaction, both affecting and being affected by many variables. Next, goal. Every day, we communicate with a variety of people, variety of reasons, in variety of ways. We have defined communication as a meaning-making system that follows the goals of conveying the intended messages from the sender to the receiver as accurately as possible. Goal. Communication conveys messages to parties involved through the different mediums such as a through speech, email, letters, and so on. In this way, people who believe in a common cause can be linked together with a view of strengthening the relationship. Next, context and the basic concept of communication, frame of reference. First, psychological frame of reference may refer to a set of parameters that define one mental schema. Ang psychological frame of reference now ay refers to the people perception frame of mind, say when they enter a communication environment. Example, a blind person may not see anything visually. His or her senses of touch and smell are typically much stronger than those who are not blind. Next, cultural frame of reference may refer to a set of parameters that define one cultural bias. A cultural frame of reference refers to the correct or ideal way of behaving within a culture, attitude, beliefs, preference, and practices considered appropriate for members of the culture. Next, social frame of reference may refer to a set of parameters that define one's social bias. Social frame of reference to the condition under which social relations are defined. That is the implicit and explicit rules of governing human behavior in every social setting. Example, gender bias, class bias, society. Certain rules are of limited to the people of certain race, gender, class. Next, spatial frame of reference may refer to the set of ecocentric experience, environmental and geographical parameters that define one's interpretation of reality. In everyday life, communication, people effortlessly translate between spatial cognitive frame of reference. Example, a tourist guide translates from a map into a cognitive frame for a tourist. Next, temporal frame of reference. Temporal frame of reference may refer to a set of translate parameters such as a space, a range of experience type that underlie imaginary representation which define one interpretation of reality. set of events along with the temporality induced by the relationship between those events. Historical frame of reference may refer to a set of parameters that define one historical bias. History occupies an enormously important place not only in a cultural collective memory but also in the life of each individual. We are told time again that we should learn from history to avoid past mistakes and as our guide for the future action. Next, the elements of communication. First, sender. Sender is the person who intended to convey the message with the intention of passing information and ideas to others is known as a sender or communicator. Oh. Next, number two, message. This is the subject matter of communication. This may be an opinion, attitude, feelings, view, orders, or suggestion. Next, encoding. And since the subject matter of communication is theoretical, its further passing requires use of certain symbols as a word, action, or picture. Next, channel. The person is interested in communicating has to choose the channel for sending the required information, ideas, or etc. This information is transmitted to the receiver through certain channels which may be either formal or informal. Next, receiver is the person who received the message or for whom the message is meant for. It is the receiver who try to understand the message is the best possible manner in achieving the desired objective. Next, decoding. The person who received the message or symbol from the communicator tries to convert the same in such a way so that he or she may extract its meaning to his complete understanding. And the last one is feedback. It's the process of ensuring that the receiver has received the message and understood in the same sense as the sender meant it. Whom? The source or the sender? What? The message? How? The medium? Whom? The receiver? Why? The influence, impact, worldview? Where? The context? Next, level of communication. Intrapersonal. Intrapersonal is defined as communicating with oneself. Some scholars have expanded communicating with oneself to include a vast range of communication, cognitive behaviors, mental entities, and knowledge and processes. Example, this can be talk to yourself, reading aloud, writing, thinking, meditating, singing, and analyzing for instances. Next, interpersonal. Interpersonal communication is an exchange of information between two or more people. It is an area of research that seeks to understand how humans use verbal and non-verbal cues to accomplish number of person and relational goals. Example of this, interpersonal communication. Communication between a son and his father, an employer and employee, two sisters, a teacher and a student, two lovers or two friends. Interviewing. Conversation is natural form of communication between people. The interview is a conversation with as a purpose and direct towards an object by the interviewer. The interview is a face-to-face meeting and discussion between two or more people for a specific purpose. Next, intercultural. Intercultural communication is the communication between people for two or different cultures. Intercultural communication is a symbolic, interpretive, transactional, contextual process in which people from different cultures create shared meanings. Example, a Christian converse with a Muslim, a woman receive an answer from a man. An American and African share their views. A Chinese politician discuss with an American leader. Next, small group of communication is the interaction among three or more people who are connected through a common purpose, mutual influence, and shared identity. Example of this small group, a college learning community focused on a math and science, a campaign teacher for a state senator. A group of local organic farmers are example of small groups that would all have different size, structure, identity, and interaction pattern. Next, the last one is mass communication. The process of creating, sending, receiving, and analyzing messages to large audience via verbal and written media. These mediums are wide-ranging and include print, digital media, and internet, social media, radio, and television. Example for mass communication is commercial advertising, public relations, journal, and political campaign. And that's for all my discussion. Thank you for listening.